Hi everybody, this is Patty, and I'm here doing something that I rarely do. I'm in front of the camera this time, but for a very special, important reason. I got the most fantastic happy mail yesterday that I want to share with you. It came from a fellow crafter who has been a fantastic supporter, always comments on every video I ever made, just gives me such great positive feedback. And you know, if you do videos like I do, or so many of us do, you get ups and downs, but for the majority of the time, most of the crafters are just special. So Cheryl Wells, if you're a member of Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations, you probably recognize that name. She lives in Texas, and she is just the sweetest person. And she asked me the other day, she says, you know, I have something I want to talk to you about. Could you give me a call? I said, well, sure. So when I called her, she said she had purchased a couple packages of antique lace, ecru lace, from a thrift store. And she thought maybe I might be interested in using it because she knows I use that kind of stuff on my projects. She also has some very special laces that were handmade, tatted and crocheted by her mother, her aunt, her sister, and I believe a grandmother. And I may not have the right laces for the right person, but that's okay. The thought is there. So I wanted to share with you what this whole conversation started with and what it ended up with. Now I'm going to turn my camera around, and I'm also going to show you some still photos of the box as I open it, just to give you a little sneak peek, because I was going to open it on camera, but it weighed a ton and it was huge, and my craft room is on the upper floor, and it was too much. So I took pictures and sent them to Cheryl as I was opening it last night. So I'll share those with you as I move my camera around. Okay, these first couple laces I wanted to share with you are ones that Cheryl's mom had made. This is absolutely gorgeous. This is crocheted and it's delicate, and there was so much. I am just honored. This is tatted, and my grandma used to tat. And I know the hours and hours, let me move that out of the way, hours and hours it takes to make something like this. You just don't sit down and womp it out. It's quite the process. So I feel very blessed. Here's another large piece that I believe Cheryl's mom made. Then there were a couple that her sister had made and an aunt. And I don't remember. I'd have to go back and look at my notes. Doesn't matter. The idea is it's just gorgeous. And here's another piece. Look at this. Isn't this just beautiful? I grew up with a grandmother that did this kind of thing, so this really touches me. Cheryl had this that came off of a gown of some sort that she shared with me. Not sure what it's going to go. I think it would be gorgeous on a mini or a box or something, but we'll put it away. It may take a while, but all of a sudden I'll think, oh, I have that Cheryl sent me. It will be perfect. I'm assuming that these were the thrift store finds that she found, and this is kind of how the conversation started, with this beautiful lace, and they're all ecru, which I love, and this one as well. This is the crochet fillet. Beautiful, beautiful. So that's how the conversation started, and from there, Cheryl says, well, I have these Graphic 45, what are these, patterns and solids. I have three of them, and they're the, who is this, Home Sweet Home. And it's pretty generic. You could use the backs for anything. She said, I think I'll stick them in. Maybe you can use them for your cards or something. I said, okay, that's great. So she sent this. You might have seen this if you follow Tammy from Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations. Cheryl got this at Hobby Lobby. Well, I don't have a Hobby Lobby anywhere near me, and it's a magnifying glass, and she stuck it in, and I thought, oh, fantastic, I don't have anything like that. If you follow my channel, you know that I am going to be starting a country mini for my very best friend, and it's for her granddaughter, and they got married last year in a barn, and they all wore cowboy boots. It was just adorable, and Cheryl says, oh, I have these packages from Recollections and Jolie. Let me see if I can get it up here so you can see. There we go. That would be just perfect for your mini. So she Sorry, guys. I'm not used to this camera setup at all, but I wanted to be able where I could show you. And then this as well. Just perfect things. They're going to be just... You'll see I'm coming because that's the next thing I'm starting on. Next, she says, I have these things from Bow Bunny that are for a baby. And she says, or children or whatever, but some of them were for a baby. And she says, I'm going to stick them in. I'm not going to use them, and maybe you'll be able to use them. Terrific. I am just thrilled at this point. Wouldn't you be? But it just keeps growing. She says, I have a couple dies. I don't know how I ended up with two of these, but one is the Sizzix Thinlets that is a Tim Holtz words, which I love this. The others is a Spellbinders, and as many of you know, I used to work for Cut at Home, and I have a lot of Spellbinders dies for when I worked with them. I don't have this one, so I was thrilled, just thrilled. This will come to great use. Thank you, Tammy. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, if any of you knew what was happening on this side of the camera, you'd be in absolute hysterics, because I'm not used to using the tripod. I'm not used to standing in front of it. So there's going to be a lot of editing done on this. Okay, the next thing Cheryl says is, do you have a Cricut? And I said, yeah, I've got the old Cricut Expression. In fact, I have the Pink Journey one. Paul bought it for me the second year we moved to Utah. So it's, I don't know, 10, 12 years old. And she says, well, she says, I upgraded to the Cricut Explore, the wireless one. And I have this one here. And she says, I'd like to gift it to you. I said, excuse me? I said, no, you can't do that. Let me purchase it from you. And she said, no, I want it to go to a home where somebody will enjoy it. And she says, I know that you would. And she says, and I don't want to see it resold on eBay or Craigslist or whatever. And I know exactly that feeling because I've had things like that happen to me. So I said, oh, wow, let me pay postage. Nope. I just want to gift it to you. So here is my new toy. Now, isn't that fantastic? I don't have anything like this. She either had the wireless Bluetooth that goes with it, so mine will be wireless as well. Cheryl, I'm just blown away, but it doesn't stop there. She says, okay, because I've had some things done with my eyes. My vision isn't what it used to be. Well, none of ours is, I'll tell you. But she says, I have a Scan and Cut, and the new Scan and Cut 2 came out with a wider screen on it. And she says, so I want to gift you my original Scan and Cut. Okay, now I'm just totally speechless. Speechless, people, from the generosity of this person. I'm getting a little glare here, but I can't help it because of the window. This was the second gift. A Scan and Cut, Brother Scan and Cut. You know, I'm a great procrastinator. I love all the toys and machines that all my crafty friends are getting, and I think about it, and I talk about it, and I never do it. You know, I just kind of plug along with what I have. A lot of us do that. And this, I am so excited about this. I went out and I purchased the mat for photos because, as many of you know, I have hundreds and hundreds of heritage photos that I'd like to scan again, and this will do it. So I have a lot of learning coming up. So this, my friends, was my happy mail from Cheryl Wells. I can't. There are just no words. There are no words for the generosity of this person. We talked for so long on the phone the other day, and I know gifts don't make a friendship. Support, love, encouragement, good words, a cheer when you need it. Those are the things that really cement the friendship. Wonderful things like this, they come and they go, and they're wonderful. But the truly important things are the things that are in your heart, and Cheryl has given me so many of those besides these fantastic, tangible items that are going to be a lovely part of my craft room. So leave a note here and tag Cheryl Wells. Give her some love. She doesn't have a blog presence, and she is posting her things on Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creation. So if you haven't joined that Facebook group, you might want to do that because she's making some lovely, lovely minis. But I have to tell you, I am just, again, blown away by this person's generosity, love, support, words just don't say enough. So, from the bottom of my heart, thank you, Cheryl. I will truly, truly enjoy these fabulous gifts that you have bestowed upon me, and I'll do you proud. I'll make something that you'll love. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Have a great crafty day, and be sure and give Cheryl some love, because, boy, she deserves it. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye now.